Web apps are everywhere, but what's the easiest way to transform your web apps into engaging and focused apps? ArcGIS Instant Apps are the easiest way to share your maps and data, and you can build them in just a few minutes.
To talk about the latest and greatest in ArcGIS Instant Apps, we are joined by our special guest. Sarah McDonald is a product engineer with the Instant Apps team at Esri Inc., and she's calling in from one of my favorite cities in the U.S., Portland, Oregon. Sarah, welcome to the podcast.
Hi. I'm happy to be here. I'm very happy to be here, actually.
We are so happy that you're here to talk about one of our favorite products, ArcGIS Instant Apps. Talk about it all the time here in the pod and in other places, so we just love talking Instant Apps.
Oh, I mean, same. I love talking Instant Apps, too. It's probably one of my favorite things to talk about. I talk about them all the time. So I'm happy to be here and talk about them a bit more.
Perfect. Why don't we start at the beginning? Because I'm sure a few of our listeners aren't necessarily familiar with Instant Apps. So why don't we just start at the top? What are ArcGIS Instant Apps?
For sure. Yes. So ArcGIS Instant Apps are purpose-driven web templates. They allow users to share their web maps as apps with their audience. As I mentioned, they're purpose-driven. So each template offers a specific purpose, such as like viewing a web map or scene, comparing content, getting directions, giving directions. You can share it with other people pretty easily. You could explore a group of content or a gallery of content. Or if you're just looking to find places that are nearby, we have a template for all of that kind of stuff and probably even more than that. So that kind of a gist of it, you know, web-based templates that are purpose-driven.
Nice. They seem pretty straightforward, but a really exciting tool. Like Mark said, we love them here at Esri Canada. They're super useful. Mm-hmm. Could you maybe explain to our listeners like why someone would want to use them, or maybe give an example of how you see them being used?
Definitely. Yeah. So Instant Apps, like I said, they allow your audience to kind of view and interact with your maps and data. But, you know, there's a lot of ways to do that, obviously, in the Esri platform, especially in ArcGIS Online. But Instant Apps are lightweight. They require no code. They are mobile responsive, so you can load them just in your mobile browser, and they should work fine. We designed them in mind as if somebody was going to open them on a desktop or open them on their phone or tablet. They're easy and quick to set up. I really want to emphasize that because, I mean, it kind of goes with the name, Instant Apps. We want to say like 5 minutes, you'll be able to pick a template, set it up, and have it published and ready to share. Most of the heavy lifting for an Instant App is going to be done on the web map side and kind of getting your content ready to share. So once you've done that, the Instant App kind of portion of it is really quick and should be very easy to use. And like I was saying, you know, most of the heavy lifting is done in the web map. So Instant Apps will really just take advantage of everything that you've done in your web map. So if you've set up charts, we have a template that can make interacting with charts really easy. If you have some fancy styles or symbology set up on your feature layers, we have some great templates that kind of take advantage of those. Viewing attachments, making it really easy, taking advantage of bookmarks and kind of, you know, taking the concept of here's just like a list of bookmarks and finding a new way to kind of interact with them. We have a few templates that make interacting with bookmarks pretty cool. And then also just finding a way to kind of take your normal pop-up and maybe give it a little bit more real estate. If you have some custom configurations, you've used Arcade to really make them kind of fancy and provide a lot of information. So, you know, that's kind of why, you know, how are they getting used? How do I see them getting used? I don't want to take up all your time, so I'll try to make this short. But, you know, one of our templates called Nearby, it's a template that you would use to, you know, find nearby locations. So whether you're just saying like, okay, in this map extent, show me all of the features from this layer. Or if I type in an address on a map, I want to find you know, all the features within half a mile. We saw this getting used a lot during COVID to find vaccine locations or vaccine appointments. It was something that, you know, really helped a lot of people. Another template that we've seen getting used a lot, Attachment Viewer. It's a template that you would use to basically take attachments that have been collected on like a feature layer. So using like field maps or, you know, Survey123, quick capture, people are in the field collecting data that has attachments. We see this getting used for like disaster response, people going out and kind of surveying like what, you know, what's happened, where there's some, you know, where there's some incidents. And then we'll see people use Attachment Viewer to kind of review all of that, like back in the office, or as like a presentation kind of resource where they're saying like, here's an overview of, you know, here's like a gallery of the attachments and a map with like, here are some densely populated points and getting kind of a feel for, you know, what the significance is. So we've seen that, that template getting used. I'm going to try to make a few more that are a little bit different. Slider is another template that we've seen get used a few times. It's a great way to display like time data and kind of animate it using the time slider. So we've seen people use this for like creating like an interactive weather forecast, especially during the winter when you see some rain and snow, things like that. And then I'll one more example, and then I'll cut myself off because I could go all of our templates and have an example. But Portfolio is another one. I've seen this app get used two different ways that I think are both pretty cool. So one of them is kind of for like emergency response, kind of like one stop shop for a collection of content. So I've seen people add in one app links or, you know, embedded web apps, embedded PDFs, embedded like, you know, external websites, and then also web maps. And it's just one link that they're able to share and people have access to all of that. Makes it really easy, you know, in a time of crisis where you're like, I just simplify everything for me. And it took me, you know, 5 to 10 minutes to set up. And so that app, I think, is like a great way. Or, you know, that use case is a great way I've seen that app get used. And then also our Living Atlas team has actually created some really cool portfolio examples where they'll take the new, I'm going to say U.S. Census 2020 data. I haven't seen any of the Canadian Census versions of this yet. I say yet, I'm sure they're coming, but where they want to show off that content. And so they have, you know, 10 or 15 different maps that have, you know, different Living Atlas layers in it. And they want to kind of create, you know, just a collection of them together and have them all be in one location. And so they've used Portfolio to do that. And so I just think, though, you know, an app that has a bunch of different use cases, but can be used to, for something that's very critical or something that's, hey, we want to show this off. This is some really cool data. Like, check this out. So a lot of different use cases that we've seen with our templates. And I'm sure there's more that I'm not talking about or that I've missed or haven't even heard of yet. But yeah, those are just some examples.
Yeah, that's amazing. There are so many different types of instant apps, and you listed a few of them there. Just kind of curious, how many templates are included with the instant apps suite at the moment?
Yes. So, great question. There are 20 templates.
Whoa.
Yeah. Kind of a growing list. And then they're both available in ArcGIS Online and ArcGIS Enterprise.
Wow, 20 is a lot of options. I'm sure that could be potentially a lot to look at when you're first starting. Do you have any tips for people on how to pick a template or how to know what to use when they're getting started?
Definitely. I definitely have some suggestions. So my first suggestion would be, you know, if somebody has seen a template that they want to create, they've seen an example of something, just go for that. You know, if they're like, I saw this online, or I saw this at the plenary, or I saw this at a demo, I want to make it, go for that. The next thing I would say is like our InstantApps homepage has a few great ways to kind of assist in making a decision on which template to use. So the first thing I will say is our suggestions tab. It's on the left side of the InstantApps homepage, but that's a great way to kind of get started. It's gonna take you through, I think it's like 4 questions, and based on how you answer, it's gonna narrow down which template that we think is maybe the best one for you to go for, based on kind of your web map, if you're using a web scene, the tools you're looking for, some of the functionality that you have in your web map. So like if you're looking for a web app or a template that supports editing, that's a great place to find, you know, you'll get narrowed down to that using the suggestions. So I would say go there first. If you're really not sure, another great place to go is our app capability search, which is also on our InstantApps homepage. It's actually right above the suggestions. But if you're just looking for certain tools, let's say you're like, I need an app that supports editing and also filtering. You can just type in edit, find edit, and then filter, and then you can find all of the apps that will support that. And then from there, you can kind of, you know, choose which one. We have a lot of information on like a basic description, and then maybe a few use case examples that are associated just on the homepage that you could access. So I would say, you know, that's another good place to go. And then if you're still really not sure and you're looking for some more inspiration, I know that's a good way that I always try to encourage people that they're, you know, they've gone through the suggestions, they're still not, the app capability search isn't really working for them. Sometimes they just need some inspiration. And our InstantApps gallery that's in our documentation, we have, you know, I want to say like at least 2, probably more than that, examples of real apps for every template that you can kind of look at and explore and just see how they're being used. And then we also have some, you know, categories that basically look at like verticals. So if you're saying, well, I'm in education and I want to try to find a template, or I'm in, you know, health and human services or something like that. I would say that those are probably going to be some of the best ways to try to choose which app or which template to use. So hopefully that should be enough to kind of get the ball rolling there. And if not, you know, try creating a few and just start playing around with it. That's another great way to kind of see what's going to work for you.
Yeah, that's really good advice. I use your gallery all the time to get inspiration about the different types of apps that are out there. You know, there are so many, so it's great to see sort of real world examples of them. So that's really good advice. I love that.
Yeah.
All right, so lots of exciting times. ArcGIS Online just had a recent update in October.
Yes.
And I'm sure there are some new things in InstantApps. So what enhancements, what cool things have been added in the recent update?
Definitely, definitely. It was a big release for us. Actually, probably for all of ArcGIS Online. But I say us because I was part, you know, I'm working on the InstantApps. But so one of our top stories was Atlas. Atlas is a template that was in beta for, I want to say, the last 6 to 9 months. And so we've pulled it out of beta for a full release during this update. And so Atlas, well, it's called a new template. And so what it does is it's able to showcase a collection of curated maps and layers. Typically, we'll see that based on like a point of interest, geographic location, or like a specific event. Some of the new features, it's always been kind of a group-based template. So your starting point would be like a group of content. And so now with Atlas, you can choose to use a group, or you can add content kind of as you go, one map or one layer at a time. And then we also added the ability to sign in and save maps in Atlas, which I think is really cool. So it's kind of another way that you can kind of take that and like build off of it. That's going to be new with Atlas. It's a really cool app. It's also like very lightweight. It's very easy to use. I think we've got a lot of use cases surrounding like education for it that I think is really awesome. Anytime we can create something that gets people involved with GIS and creating maps, I'm get really excited about it because I'm a huge map nerd. So it, I'm I'm like guilty. so yeah, Atlas is something that, like I said, out of beta this release. Another feature I really want to talk about is our language switcher. It's going to be a component that's available in 5 of our templates, nearby, zone lookup, media map, interactive legend, and sidebar. And it's a really cool component that I think a lot of people are going to be excited about, because it basically allows you to include the option to provide multiple translations for in-app text. So if you're a city, a state, or a province, and let's say that you're creating an app for your residents, and you have to support multiple languages, you know, very common, especially not only in the US, but in Canada as well. And so basically what the language switcher component does is it allows you to basically any in-app text that you would create in Instant Apps, so like your app title, an introduction window, certain labels for certain other, like certain components in our app that you're adding in text for that. We basically create a way for you to translate that text. And then in your launched app, you can switch between languages for it. So if you have, you know, you have your app that opens up in English, but then you also have the ability to kind of translate it in the launched app to Spanish. We then switch the language, not only in the app, so any like hover tips, basically like changing the language in the app, but then all of your kind of in-app text that you've added will then also translate as well. And so that's, and this is kind of our first version of it. We do, you know, we are going to keep looking into it and building on that too. But it is a really cool feature and a big step forward, I think, for a lot of our templates, and we're hoping to get it into more also too in the future. But yeah, that's like another cool component that is new for this release. Another thing that we had in this release is it's going to be a new template, but it's in beta. It's called Manager. If anybody has ever heard of Crowdsource Manager or worked with it, this is going to be the replacement for that. Or if you've never heard of Crowdsource Manager and you're like, what's that? You can just look at Manager as a very basic editing app that makes editing data in one map or multiple maps really simple and pretty straightforward to do. And so that's new in this release as well. And then, you know, we've added attribute filtering into a lot more of our templates. We added attribute filtering into attachment viewer, media map, 3D viewer, which I think is really cool. Now you can have the ability to filter features in a web scene using our 3D viewer app. And then I'm trying to think if we added into any more templates. I think those are it. And then the last thing I'll talk about, because there's more, but I just, you know, I don't want to just list everything, is our map area component. This component we had last release just in our slider template, but we've added it into most of our apps. I just say most because I think there's like 4 apps that it's not in, mostly because it doesn't really make sense in them. But this new component basically allows you to update your default map view, or like update where in the map your app will open to, which is pretty cool. I think this is something that we've seen in a few other places in ArcGIS Online with web apps, but you know, we've added the ability in our templates now. So if you're, you know, you're using a web map maybe that you didn't make, or you have a general web map and you, for the app that you're building, you really want to focus in on a different place, you can use that map area component to do that. And then you, and the other piece of map area is to create a navigation boundary. So not only are you going to load your map into a specific place, but you can kind of keep people within a certain location. And so I think that that's really cool, because as somebody who loves maps, if I open a map, I find myself like not only focused on the place that the app is supposed to be on, but then I'm like, well, what's over here? And I want to go check out this. And where am I at? And what the navigation boundary will basically do is just kind of keep everybody centrally located in your application on the area of interest. And so it's just a way to kind of focus people in, keep them located where you're trying to show your information. So yeah, those are some of the new things. Very exciting. Yeah,
it sounds amazing. You were not kidding about it being a big release for you guys. Lots of stuff there. I know all of it sounds exciting. I can't wait to start trying it. I'm really excited about the language switcher. I know, yeah, for our bilingual users, which we have a lot, it's going to be a game changer. Don't have to keep making double apps all the time. So that's huge.
Oh, yeah. No, that's a big one. I know that when we've been kind of working on that feature, we've had some kind of what we call stakeholders that have been like really leading the charge for it. So it's going to be, and like I said, this is kind of our first release of it. And as we continue to develop it, I think it's just going to grow and get better over time. So yeah,
absolutely. It's a great step towards bilingual everywhere. So that's exciting. So yeah, you shared a lot of really great stuff with us today. Hopefully our listeners are getting excited about instant apps. We don't want to keep you around for your whole afternoon. So just morning for you, different time zones, but just one last question we want to ask, same thing we ask all of our guests on the show. It's a lot to remember. So if you can give our listeners just three main takeaways about ArcGIS Instant Apps that hopefully sticks with them, what would you say are the top three things you want to drive home?
Definitely. So first thing, as an app author, Instant Apps are going to be really quick and easy to set up. So if you're in a bind, look at an Instant App if you need to share some data and you only have maybe 5 minutes. Instant Apps, quick and easy. Number two, our apps are designed to be simple to interact with. So not only as an app author, but as somebody who's creating an app for an audience that might not have any knowledge of GIS or Esri at all, our apps are very simple and lightweight to use. And so that's another thing I will mention. And then the last thing is our apps are purpose-driven. So we create apps to support real life use cases. And so that is one thing that I will mention, that our templates do have a focus. And so if you are looking for, specific use cases that, you know, trying to find the right one, that's going to be kind of critical with it. But, we do try to cover as many bases as we can with all of our templates. And so, those are the three things I would, leave everybody with. But yeah, like I said, I could keep going, but those three, I will leave it with that.
Well, that's incredible, Sarah. And yes, yeah, those are really good points to really hammer home. And okay, I'm going to slip in one silly question.
Yes.
Do you have a favorite instant app?
Oh man, I definitely do. It's hard for me to not be biased because I work on a lot of, obviously I work on the team and I work with a bunch of our developers to build them. I would say my favorite one that we have right now is probably Attachment Viewer. I just say that because I've been working on it for a while. And I think that when people come to me and they don't know about Instant Apps at all, it's the template that I show people that they're like, I get it. Like I understand what you guys are doing now just by seeing that template. Because when I say purpose driven and I say, if you have a feature layer with attachments and you say, I want to make these attachments easy to, easy to navigate and see them, Attachment Viewer basically takes it. You don't have to do anything else and it just displays them for you. And so I would say that's probably my favorite template just because the story of it just fits in so perfectly and it just clicks. I also think it has some really cool use cases. Like people use it for, like I said, disaster response, but they also use it just to like show fun things, like public art around the city or, like one of the apps I'm kind of always trying to create is like fun bike racks here in Portland. Like a lot of businesses will have like really cool like bike racks out front that they've kind of like had somebody come in and make. And so I try to take pictures of them while I'm like walking throughout the city or whatever. And So I kind of have this collection going, and so I'm like, it's going to be the perfect attachment viewer app once I like feel good with the data set, you know? And so yeah, I would say attachment viewer is probably my favorite, but they're all so cool. You know, they all have so many like cool purposes. I mean, can I ask you guys, do you guys have any favorite instant apps?
Put us on the spot.
Yeah.
I am a big fan of Nearby. I think Nearby has a lot of really useful cases, and I know I've seen examples of how our user community is taking advantage of Nearby. So thumbs up to Nearby. I like that one.
Yeah. I was almost gonna say Nearby too, but I'll go to my next favorite, which is the slider. I love a time slider. It's flashy. See the progress over time, and it's so easy to use, just like all the instant apps, but it's real quick and it creates a great map in the end.
Nice. Yeah, those are two powerhouse templates, I would say, like really powerful. I mean, they're all pretty powerful. It's like hard to call one better than the other because you're like, oh, well, they all do these cool things, you know? So yeah, no, those are great ones though.
Awesome. Well, Sarah, we really appreciate your time and talking to us today about ArcGIS Instant Apps. So thank you very much for joining our pod.
Yeah, thanks for having me. I really appreciate it. And yeah, thanks.
Thank you, Sarah. That was Sarah McDonald, a product engineer for ArcGIS Instant Apps at Esri Inc. And she joined us today from Portland, Oregon.